I follow a journalist on Twitter named Julie Brown who really broke the Jeff Epstein case. And I've contacted Julie saying, hey, just so you know, jails are built so you can't kill yourself. Like, there's no way to tie up the rope to hang yourself in a jail. It's just how jails are built. And if this guy tried to commit suicide a week before, they would have never put him in a place where he could commit suicide. But apparently no one cares about that. All right, so that made me want to go through the rest of Time 100's top people. And the first person I saw on the list is Megan Thee Stallion. I've never heard of her, or at least I hadn't heard of her until I think Wet Ass Pussy, right? WAP, which is Cardi B's new song. So I don't know anything about her. She's a rapper. Giannis Antetokounmpo, I don't know who he is. He's from the NBA. He was MVP twice. But I still feel like LeBron James is more influential. All right, so Ibram X. Kendi, he was a Black Lives Matter, he's a writer, but I don't know what he writes. But he's Black Lives Matter, and I think he writes about race. Nathan Law, I knew who he was. He's a Hong Kong activist. He's an activist from Hong Kong, and he is an activist that has failed, but he has at least gotten the world's attention. All right, so Tomi Adeyemi, she is a writer. She writes sci-fi, and I've never heard of her, but she's Black. I think they're trying to pick Black people, but I also think she could be that good of a writer. I haven't read her stuff. I love sci-fi that much that I might read it if they make a movie. All right, so there are two astronauts, Christina Koch and Jessica Meir. I never heard of them, but they are female astronauts. And then Cecilia Martinez, she is an environmentalist. I've never heard of her. I feel like I haven't heard of a lot of these people. Maya Moore, she's from the WNBA. She's from the women's basketball. That's a pretty difficult group of people to come from to be influential. But I do understand that some people do like women's basketball a lot. All right, so I've noticed they picked a lot of lawyers, but this person, Chase Strongio, is a transgender activist from the ACLU, and I feel like if there's any group of people that still need people to be activists on their behalf, it's the transgender community, because it's dangerous to be transgender, sometimes at least. All right, so Zhang Yongzhen, I don't know how to say his name. He's a virus expert. He's on the list. I'm guessing he's Chinese. I feel like he's leading the Chinese effort against the coronavirus, and he did a very good job at it. All right, so there's Tourmaline, which is a filmmaker and activist. Another person I haven't heard of. A lot of these people I haven't heard of, which makes me think I need to just take this list and contact them about my situation, because it looks like it's like actually a pretty serious activist list. Waldo Khatib is a war reporter from Syria. She's female and she's pretty good looking. Abu Bakr, Tom. I know I'm going through the entire list, but I'm just saying, what I was actually trying to say is the list looked pretty weak because Julie Brown, who I don't think has fully investigated the Jeff Epstein situation. Then I looked at another part of the list, the artists, and I saw that there is no Miley Cyrus. And she is like massively inspirational for, especially for gay and trans people. Because she has worked so hard to normalize it to the world. Which brings me to my next point. So Oasis, when I was growing up, they were one of my favorite bands because Wonderwall and Champagne Supernova, they're not super on the Titty Mount, which means they have 3+ songs, but they've made the Titty Mount with Don't Look Back in Anger. And they're pretty good. All right, so this guy is talking crap about Miley, saying she dresses like a slut, blah, 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 blah. She doesn't dress like a slut. She dresses up in outfits when she performs, and sometimes that involves using her sexuality. She does actually take pictures that are pretty sexy on the internet sometimes, now that I think about it. Yeah, I don't really like that she does that, but she can do whatever she wants. Me, I'm gonna do whatever I do, which means, like, I'm an entertainer. And when you're an entertainer, you sometimes want to take off your shirt to go entertain people. Even if, let's face it, Do y'all want to see the whole thing? No, you just want to see from here up, and then I'll look sexier. All right, so some people, their entertainment is in a tiny little box, and that's why they had a really good song, and they still hit their peak a long time ago. Like, people that are actual entertainers adapt, and they change, and they think about how they entertain, and they try to entertain in all different ways, and so I think Oasis should consider the fact that Miley's an entertainer. Anyways, Yo-Yo Ma is on this list. I think that's pretty weak. I think this list is curated by like some like fancy like tea drinker that has their finger. Trust me, let's make sure to include plenty of black people. Oh, can you tell me the distribution of each race before we publish this list? I guarantee you there's someone that wanted to know the distribution of like racial, like, and I understand you got to make the perfect list. And John Roberts is on there. Some of these people are important. Like, I don't know how to say his name. Jair Bolsonaro. He's from Brazil. He told everyone not to wear masks. So he was influential in that way. Bill Barr is influential. That's the thing. He's very, very influential. Anne Hidalgo is the mayor of Paris. And she was very influential in France. I don't know. Mary Kay Henry, that's probably true that she's that influential. She's a union leader. But I feel like they also are especially careful to make sure there are women, that are, women make up a certain percentage of the list, which is fine. Who is missing from this list? Is the CEO of Microsoft on this list? No, he's not. All right, well, the list is okay. I'm gonna stop talking about it. Who's really missing? I have a list. The Joint Chiefs of Staff are missing from this list, from the American military. They're who make decisions for the American military. General Nakasone, who is the director of the NSA, is not on the list. Chris Wray, who's the director of the FBI, is not on the list. Gina Haspel is not on the list, and she's the director of the CIA. Mike Pompeo was the director of the CIA until I started accusing him of blackmailing the president, and then he got promoted to become Secretary of State. But he was director of the CIA, and he's Secretary of State, so he's should be at the very top of the most influential people list. The Freedom Caucus, which a Freedom Caucus member is the current chief of staff. The Freedom Caucus is like the most influential group of people in the Congress. They should be on the list. Mitch McConnell, who is the Senate, like he's the Senate majority leader. He's kind of who like controls what happens in the Senate. He's not on the list. And Mitch McConnell's from a small state, you know, Kentucky. Kentucky has a small population relative to everyone else. But he has that much power. But small state senators have a lot of power. If you haven't noticed, Lisa Murkowski and what's her name, Susan Collins, both of them are from like tiny, tiny states. But they're senators. First thing they say when the Supreme Court justice pick time comes is, I am not going to vote for a Supreme Court justice because they're setting the bar. You're going to have to allow me to have a lot of influence over who is chosen in this process is what they're saying. And that's because they're senators that can be swing votes, but they're actually swing votes that are from tiny little states. So that gives those little tiny states a lot of power. All right. So I think the list is kind of stupid. You guys did a really bad job on it. It's kind of like picking the most influential person in the entire world is the Pope. But then the Pope hasn't even made the list this year, but the Pope before, back when he was kissing feet and doing absolutely nothing, and he making everyone like the Pope, he became Time Person of the Year. Time is like that. They're not thinking about who's actually influential. It doesn't matter.